Let us implement and simulate full adder circuit on the PSpice software. So here is the respective truth table. We know that in case of full adder, we shall be having 3 input lines and 2 output lines. So 3 input lines are let there be x, y and z, and 2 output lines are carry and sum. So this is a full adder truth table we are having. As we are having 3 input lines, so we shall be having 8 input combinations. So 1, 2, 3, 4 in this way, we are having 8 combinations and we are having the respective carry and sum. To get the Boolean function of this carry and sum, we have plotted the respective Carnot maps. So this is the Carnot map we are having. So here we are having, we are plotting this carry. So 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1. So we are plotting in this way 0, 0, 0, 1 and 0, 1, 1, 1. In this way, the function we have got is this one. So let us go for this sum. It is 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1. So 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1. So we have got this one. So there is a very famous expressions for Boolean functions for carry and sum respectively. So here we require from this functions, we are finding that we require 7404, that is a 7408 rather, 2 input quad and get IC. So we require 7486, that is a 2 input quad. Quad means 4 pieces will be there, so quadruple. So 2 input quad XOR get IC, and we require 7432 for 2 input quad OR get IC. So these 3 ICs I will be requiring for the implementation. So let us check that how we have implemented the same in our PSpice software. We know that using half adders also we can implement full adder. So 2 half adders and 1 external OR gate can also we can also implement full adder circuit accordingly. So here is the respective circuit for us. So that is 1 half adder. We know that in case of half adder we require 1 XOR gate, 1 AND gate. So those 2 inputs which will be going to the XOR gate, the same inputs will be going to the AND gate. So that is also another half adder. So 2 inputs are going to the XOR gate, same 2 inputs will be going to the AND gate. So here these 2 AND gates will be ORed through this particular IC, and here you will be getting the carry. So and this one is XOR, YXOR, Z. So I will be getting this one as sum. So here we have implemented the full adder using 2 half adders and 1 external OR gate. So these are the respective inputs are there, these are the respective outputs are there. I think it would be better if we get the parts list, that is, that means what are the parts required for the implementation of this circuit. So this is the part list for us. So 7408, that is 2 input quad AND gate IC. 7432, that is 2 input quad OR gate IC. 7486, 2 input quad XOR gate IC. If out, that is the output, whatever we are getting, that is carry and sum, and ditch stim for the digital input and the stimulations. So full adder circuit design and PSpice and simulation in PSpice will be done through these parts. Now let us go for the simulation output of the respective circuit. So here is the simulation output we are having. Okay, now see, for this X, Y and Z, so Z is the MSB here and X is the respective LSB. So now here you see, we are having 0.5 nanosecond, we are keeping this one low, and 0.5 nanosecond, we are keeping this one high for this Z, for this X. For this Y, we are keeping this one as 1 nanosecond low and 1 nanosecond high. And for the respective Z input, we have made this one as 2 nanosecond low and 2 nanosecond high accordingly. So as a result of that, we are getting all the 8 combinations like this one: 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, and so on up to 1, 1, 1. And this is the respective output of the carry and sum, the respective timing diagram. So let us go for one demonstration, practical demonstration of this full adder circuit onto the PSpice software. So that will bring better clarity in our understanding. So here is the demonstration for you. I'm going to have my full adder circuit implementation. So I require ditch stim. So Ctrl R for rotate. So 3 inputs I require, because full adder circuit
is having three input lines. So I'm changing the levels. So XYZ is this one, we are having this XYZ. Now I require to have one XOR gate. So the IC number is 7486. I'm getting them in the cache because I've used these ICs earlier in the earlier circuits, in the earlier videos. So I require this one XOR gate here and another XOR gate I require here. So two XOR gates I require. I also require two AND gates. So the IC number is 7408. So that is one AND gate I require. I require another AND gate here. And then I require one OR gate. So that is IC number is 7432. So I require one OR gate. So I'm just putting my OR gate here. I require one digital output if out. I'm putting it here. Another if out, I'm putting it here. So in this way, I have planned my circuit accordingly. Now let me connect all these gates now. So I require this XOR Y at first. And this XOR Y will be also coming here to get X and Y. This output will be obtained here as input, and here I require this Z to be coming. So it is my XOR Y and it is my Z. So the output is XOR Y XOR Z, and that is my sum. Okay. The inputs which are going to the XOR gate, the same inputs will be coming to the AND gate also. So the inputs which are going to the XOR gate must be coming to the AND gate also. Now this AND gate outputs are to be ORed. And then I'm going to have my final output. So it will be my sum. And it should be my carry. So in this way, my circuit has been drawn. Okay, now that is my circuit. So now let me test my circuit accordingly. Let me test my circuit. So here I'm putting one rectangular box only to indicate that this is the section I'm going to have. Address part is my inputs and outputs. So this rectangular box is encapsulating this circuit. And then I'm putting my voltage levels. So voltage level carry, and then I'm putting one for sum, one for Z, one for Y, another one for X. So now I'm just clicking. Giving this one as 4 millisecond. On time will be 2 millisecond. We did this one earlier also. This one, I'm making this one as 2 millisecond. This is my 1 millisecond. Apply OK. Applying this one. So now it is fine. It is working fine. Now this is my setup analysis. So if you click on the analysis setup, so transient, print step is 0.5. I require 8 different combinations because we are having 3 input lines. So I'm making this one as 4 millisecond. So 0.5 millisecond will be the step and 4 millisecond will be the final time. So I shall be having 8 combinations in this way. Closing it. Now I shall go for the simulation. Everything is ready for me. Let us go for the simulation. So simulate. So simulation output has come and it is working fine. Some errors are there. Let me check. So this particular line has got connected. So that's why that is the source of the error. So I'm just deleting this one. I'm drawing this line again. You can find that what are the different errors are there that may occur. You see, there is no dot here. So there is no bullet type of thing here. So that indicates that it is not connected. So such errors will be occurring when you are going to draw your own circuit. But how to rectify that one, that is the main thing to learn. So now if I execute my code, my circuit here. So I'm getting the required output accordingly. So I'm getting this, you can easily find that. Okay, see, so here we are having this. So that is my, you can plot in this way. There is a user defined, that is 0 millisecond to 4 millisecond. So accordingly you can go. So that is the x-axis. You can also change it here if you require. So for this is my 0 0 0, then the sum will be 0, carry will be 0. Then we are having this 0 0 1, because we are having this. I think they are not coming in the proper order. So let me go for erase, then delete all traces. Let me bring. So I want to bring at first x, then y, then z, then carry, and then sum. So in this way, I'm just making them available in the sequence. Going for OK. Now they are coming in my own sequence as I desire. So 0, 0, 0 will bring us sum 0 and carry 0. Then 0, 0, 1, carry 0, sum 1. 0, 1, 0, carry 0, sum 1. And then 0, 1, 1, I'm getting this carry 1 and sum 0. Then we're having this 1, 0, 0, carry 0, sum 1. We're having 1, 0, 1. So carry 1, sum 0. We're having this 1, 1, 0. So carry 1, sum 0. We're having this 1, 1, 1. So carry 1 and sum also 1. In this way, within 4 milliseconds, I'm getting all the possible 8 combinations accordingly. I think you are getting the idea that how to draw the circuit, how to simulate, when error will come, then in the simulation, how the lines are coming with the red colors. And then you should have to judge your circuit. You should have to check whether you have made error in which location. You should have to rectify that one. And at the end, you should run the circuit with full success. If you are having any kind of doubts and difficulties, please share them with us through the comment block given below. And thanks for watching this video.